okay. I'm just glad that you're okay. Now, where are you? The bathroom. All right, good choice. Though I'm unsure if you have a lot to protect yourself with in there. Wait, is there a medicine cabinet in there? If there is, take a look inside. See if you can find some medicine of some sort. I've heard that the effect that is created as soon as you take some types of medicine will drive the spirits away. Don't ask how. Maybe the reaction the medicine creates makes them think that you're dead or something. Either way, I think this is your only hope. Stay quiet, track them on the camera, and if they should find you, quickly swallow a pill or something. Then they should hopefully go away. Take the strongest medicine you can find. However, strong medicines often come with some side effects, like temporary loss of long-distance vision, loss of short-distance vision, paralysis, etc. But don't worry, these side effects will go away shortly. Keep moving during the day, okay? And I'll call you again tomorrow if you're still there. Be careful.
Okay. Hi, this is Max. I'm just checking to see how you're doing. So, how did it go last night? You didn't feel sick or anything after eating those pills, did you? Huh? Did you take the very strong medicine? Oh, boy. Well, I was the one who told you to do so. So, the thing is, the side effects from those strong medicines don't come straight away. This means you might experience them tonight. The most common side effect is hallucination. You might think you see a normally friendly face that you've seen before, but since you're currently in this frightening situation, you might see it as something truly evil. If you see something strange on the camera, quickly switch to another camera or pull it down. If you see a hallucination in your office, though, you should then pull your pad up again. You just want to look away quickly before your mind tricks you completely. Now, in this bedroom, you have a neat tool. This is probably where the parents slept, and they wanted to control the whole house. Do you see the cable on the ground that leads into the wall? Have you plugged it into your pad? Good. Now you can make static noises play in the room you're looking at by simply touching your pad. If you see some familiar ghosts, try tapping the screen many times. Hopefully the noise will scare them away because you don't really have anything else to protect yourself with in there. Okay, good night, and stay safe. I can hear your heavy breath through the phone. Having a good time? I'm sure you are. They'll never find me. I'm too fast for them. I know this world better than any of those fools out there. And what about you? Can you hide? Can you hide from us? We're coming after you. But I'm sure you've figured that out already. Though, have you figured out where the exit is? I'm sure you haven't. So, are you him? The one who did it? You sure look a lot like him. If so, let us finish what we started on back in the factory. All those years ago.
Hey there, sorry for the late phone call. I had some work that needed to get taken care of. Man, you've been there for many nights now. You must feel like a security guard or something. Okay, so where are you hiding? Oh, in the laundry, you say. Well, there are two doorways into the laundry, and since the room is very small, they will see you and most likely get to you should they come inside. Do you remember what I said about eye contact? Good. So, sit with your back faced against the door. Oh, you already are. Great. Now, things might get a bit complicated tonight. Since you can't look behind you, you must listen carefully to know if someone is standing behind your back. But it's very important to know who is standing behind you. Watch the cameras to know which one enters the laundry. This is important since all ghosts will react differently when they see you. If a, should we say, a shy or more nervous type of ghost enters your room, try to quickly look from left to right until he goes away. That should hopefully confuse him, as he's probably already confused enough to begin with. Though, should a tall or more aggressive ghost find you, sit completely still and don't move. You will hear it when they go away, as the sound of their breath will vanish. However, just to be sure, you should turn on the machine you see in the left-hand corner. Just click the button on it. My guess is that some specific type of ghost will avoid that annoying sound from the machine. Should any of these ghost types find you, they probably won't get fooled and no matter what you do. So to keep these away, keep the machine on. The only downside to this, however, is that the loud sound will make you unable to hear anyone behind you.
Please, I'm getting chased again.
Be
careful tonight,
man. And good luck.
Man, my mind. Stop getting Tim here. No! No, go to jail!
What?
Hey man, good evening. So, how are you? Are you doing
being
good?
Chased.
Man, I tell you what, the police have been crazy active today, and honestly, they're still at it. Someone must have done something really bad. Okay, tell me, where did you hide? What? Come again? A cellar? You've got to be joking, right? There's no cellar in that house, right? No, I'm positive. When we investigated the house several years ago, there was no sign of any basement whatsoever. I'm sorry, but I cannot help you here. I have no idea what it's like down there, and since you're underground, the cameras probably won't work either. You could always use a night vision camera to look around your room, though. But that will drain your battery extremely fast. Because of this, you might also have to charge it up manually. Otherwise, just remember what I said about the eye contact.
Oh, no.
See what you can find down there, and honestly, try and stay safe, man. I'm not sure if... Hey, what are you doing in here? This is for employees only. I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to ask you to...
Oh, you look a lot like him. Are you the one?
I'm getting chased.
Are you the one? Are you the one? Are you the one?
Go with it, Jeff.
Oops.
No, you're going to
Looks
jail.
Like he wasn't the one.
Oh my god.
But to you, let me come over and check myself. See you there.
Go there. Go the fuck to sleep. Why is it getting chased by snail? Oh no. Man, I'm getting chased. Works every time. Go the fuck to sleep. Yeah. Rip. Bro. Rip. Go the This one's very scary. Go the fuck to sleep. And you say bad word again.
What?
No way. Hell
so it
no.
Wasn't you either.
Not them on.
Strange. You two look so similar. We will make him apologize. We will keep searching.
What the
hell? Forever.
Stop it! Now! Sorry, dude. I got the bad ending. Maybe I can restart the game. I can't believe the creepiest game. Wait! I just select. Game of Wild Games. Wait, this one's always scary.
Hello? Oh, thank God. You're in the house, God. Right? Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Max. I'm one of the employees at your new job, but that's not important right now. What is important is for you to get out of there. I know someone hired you to watch over the house tonight because the family who was living there is on vacation.
I want sandwich now!
Blah, blah, blah. Well, I don't know who told you that this house needed some sort of protection, but I'm pretty sure it was a prankster. You need to get out of there. That house you're in is apparently extremely haunted, and according to some files I have here, nobody has been living there for years. I'm not sure what kind of hauntings that exist in that house, but one thing is clear. I'm sure they are trying to get to you by playing with your mind. You might even go crazy and see the exit door as a hallway, for example. Stay focused, all right? I could come over, but I'm afraid that can make things even worse. Now, you must not move from the spot you're on during the night, all right? It's extremely dangerous in this situation. It's a good thing you put up the cameras throughout the building. Use them well. But keep in mind that you can only use them for a limited amount of time at once. Yeah. Watch the power meter to make sure you don't need to charge it all the way back up. If someone should come in on the left-hand side, look to the opposite side of the room and wait. Don't look at your camera, just wait. You don't want to make eye contact, understand? Though in this room, they might sneak up behind you as well. I'm guessing you will then see them in the mirror above the fireplace. If this should happen, immediately pull up your camera to make them go away. Got it? You should also watch them on the camera as often as you can, as it somehow makes them go a bit slower.
Open the light now.
Once the sun rises, you are free to look for the exit. But remember, as I said, you might have trouble finding it. Heck! They might even shut the doors and windows completely.
Abba,
if you don't find a way out by tomorrow night, I'll give you another call. But do not, and I repeat, do not stay in the same room two nights in a row, okay? That will make you easier to find. Good night.
Say bad word.
Yes.
Are you kidding? You are all grounded. Oh my God.
I see Paw Patrol. Let me see, Mama. I want Paw Patrol.
I went so fast.
Yeah.
me worried throughout the whole day. So, where are you located? The kitchen, huh? I see. That's a good choice there. As you have probably already noticed, it's very dark tonight. It's cloudy, the moon is small. Yeah, I'm not sure if you're able to see very much in there, but luckily, this is the kitchen we're talking about. You have an oven, or should we say a free light source, kinda. I doubt any of those electrical ovens work, but there's an old oven behind the desk there. If you put some fuel in, it should light up the room for a little while. However, be very careful. Ghosts can sense the light from very far away. And since you only have a limited supply of fuel, you should only use it when you know someone is standing in your room. Got it? This is where you must use your security cameras effectively. Follow them. Track them. This way you'll know if they're in the room with you or not. The scary thing is, if you light up your room while someone is in there with you, they will for sure go away. That's a fact. However, if no one is there, they will most likely come rushing towards you and you must just hope for the best. So only use your fuel when you absolutely need to. Keep at it, stay safe, and stay calm. Good night. You're in the house, right? Allow me to introduce myself.